Welcome back. In the last class, we have discussed about the formation of images in concave mirrors. Today, we are going to discuss the next topic in this chapter, and that is magnification. Look at the figure which shows the formation of image by a concave mirror. We can measure the height of object and height of image. OB, that is the object here, and let it be HO. IM is the image and it be HI. Measure the height of the object and height of the image. Using this, we can calculate the ratio of height of the image to the height of the object. And it is magnification. Magnification is the ratio of height of the image to the height of the object. And this number indicates how many times the size of object is the size of the image. Magnification M equal to HI divided by HO. While calculating the magnification, the measurement taken upwards from the principal axis is considered as positive, and the measurements downwards are considered as negative. Magnification is a physical quantity having no unit. Let's see a problem related to this. Calculate the magnification if an object of height 3 cm kept in front of a concave mirror which gives a real image of size 6 cm. We know magnification M equal to HI divided by HO. Height of the object is given as 3 cm and height of the image is given as 6 cm. So, 6 divided by 3. Remember one thing. While calculating magnification, those measurements which are taken downwards are considered as negative. We know if the image is real, it is inverted. So, we have to give the height of the image as negative 6. Magnification M equal to negative 6 divided by 3, that is equal to negative 2. Next, we are going to see the uses of spherical mirrors. Concave mirrors. Concave mirrors are used as shaving mirror, makeup mirror, head mirrors used by doctors, and in film projectors. Uses of convex mirror. They are used as reflectors in street lamps. They are used as rear view mirrors by drivers for viewing vehicles from behind. These mirrors have a wide field of view compared to that of plain mirrors. Hence, they can help in avoiding accidents to a certain extent. And big convex mirrors helps in viewing vehicles coming beyond curves, thus minimizing accidents. Students, our fifth chapter, Reflection of Light in Spherical Mirrors, has completed. In this chapter, you have studied some technical terms related to spherical mirrors, focus and focal length of spherical mirrors, ray diagram, how image is formed in a spherical mirror, its characters, and also the uses of spherical mirrors. Study well. See you in the next class. Thank you.